How about we finish up my story?
I am listening.
Last time I was telling you how Sigrun training with her, I never put all that only...
Yours.
Damn right. I had just one eye foot. I'm not... It's not my point.
Thank you.
It's encouraging to know Valhalla wants to help.
The elite enemies Valhalla has chosen for you to target will only continue to manifest. You must adapt and employ all available resources, or you will fall again.
Is that a key?
One from my past.
Did it unlock something important?
Only a memory.
Seems Valhalla thinks you have a story to tell.
Later.
Greetings, friends. Any questions before you get started?
I was wondering, actually. Did Odin ever try his hand at Valhalla?
Of course. He explored it very thoroughly, in seeking to gain control of the Valkyries. But in the end, he found nothing here he could use. You see, Odin always looked outside himself for answers. But Valhalla only reveals its secrets to those who do the work of looking in.
We've come this far. Anything we need this moment. This one wants a price from you, brother.
Hmm.
careful. Who knows what's waiting for you in that mist?
The wee bastard's about to explode!
Thank you.
Sigmund has been important to you for as long as I have known you. What happened in the beginning?
Oh, it's a typical enough story. A boy meets girl, girl fulfills her ambition to transcend the physical plane and become a Valkyrie of Valhalla. One day, Sigrid quietly arrived from Fjordalund and began serving as Freya's handmaiden while she undertook training for the Sisterhood. I don't even think we were introduced. I just see her around the court. Of course, I'd observed her loveliness and impressive stature but long before we fell to talking. Cut from different cloth, I suppose. It never occurred to me we'd get along as well as we did.
Has lifted. Let's make it worthwhile.
Ah!
Valhalla keeps the score. Should be unlocked now, shall we? Kratos, the key you found. Whose was it? What did it unlock?
It belonged to a boat captain I met during a battle on the Aegean Sea. His ship was part of a fleet called the Sapphire Hydra. The key unlocked his quarters, where I heard women screaming for help.
Ah, yes. The story of your fight with the three-headed sea serpent. You impaled one of its heads on the ship's mast, was it?
Yes. But that battle is not why this key appeared. It is my killing of the boat captain for it that seems to follow me wherever I go.
I'm back to brighten your day. Don't hurry up and make a decision on my account. Spotted your quarry. Disrupted, you halfwit! Targets. You'd better hurry. Enemies will only get tougher the longer you take here. Come on. these lowlifes.
You blind behind you!
It's coming back here! Decisions, decisions.
Back again. Still not used to that.
Good to see you again, Kratos. I brought something else to keep things interesting. You're not the only one with weapons from far-off lands, you know. Ready?
Defend yourself!
Don't get distracted! Now you're fighting to win!
Ambitious. Proud. I could not accept defeat. I crave power.
Is that all? Are you sure? Nothing more to that story? Nothing else under the surface?
I yield, Kratos.
Very well.
I believe you found an understanding within yourself. Shall we see?
Fools. It's not only memories.
Indeed. For what is a memory apart from our perspective on it? You know the evils that came of your path. You know the evils within yourself. Yes, these you dwell on. But it's not that simple, is it?
The Horde is vast, brother. What would have happened if you didn't stop it?
our lands would have been overrun. Our people killed, violated.
People your army was sworn to protect. An army led by you. Did you not feel a duty to fulfill your purpose? Did you not fear for the safety of your homeland? You saved them.
You would excuse my actions.
Excusing them is not the exercise, Kratos. Only accepting them. Accepting that you acted based on what you knew then, not on what was to come. Your motivation and their consequences are far more complicated than you let yourself believe. I think perhaps you have more to process.
Yes. I have much to think about. I will return.
And I will be waiting.
Yourself to Valhalla.
Heir.
A gift. To adapt is to find the bridge between where you are and where you want to be.
If Valhalla is offering some help, I'd take it.
That benefit's good to last.
We're all impressed by your progress, Jim. We've never seen anyone engage Valhalla quite the way you have.
Sigrun, I wanted to tell you. Valhalla keeps sweeping me away to my own adventure in memory.
I wondered if it would. That's wonderful. What is it showing you?
Some particular events of my wayward youth. But they're in a loop of sorts. Not sure I've quite gleaned what it all amounts to.
Then you must do what you do in Valhalla. Keep going.
Since we keep going back in, I take it this process is working for you somehow.
Yes. Succeed or fail, I feel progress. Clarity. I need to see it through.
Very good, brother.
An infamous act, one they still spoke of in the years of rebuilding. I somehow doubted they meant it so literally.
I'll give you this, brother. Your technique has improved immeasurably.
I needed his power to secure my vengeance against the gods. I believed I had no choice.
No choice? You could have not ripped my head off my body. That was absolutely an option.
And he's back.
But that wasn't the worst of it, was it, Kratos?
Killing me deprived Greece of the sun. They were plunged into perpetual cold and darkness. Crops ceased to grow.
Famine descended on our homeland.
Not that you cared.
Enough.
He is better, isn't he?
Kratos, I'm curious. Your decision to behead Helios, was it fueled by any personal motivations? Or was it really just a means to an end?
It was not personal. I did know him long before I killed him. He was as insufferable as any god. But his death brought me no satisfaction.
Did you know what would happen as a result?
When Helios was captured by the God of Dreams, the lands fell into darkness and were not restored until his return. I knew exactly what would happen.
Kratos, I hope you'll forgive me for overhearing. But before you first found your way to me, you were grappling with the symbolism of your former seat of power. May I offer a perspective?
You may.
Before I became God of War, I felt as hesitant as you do. I feared that taking the throne would only validate Odin's power hierarchy, which even then I didn't trust. But I decided I could wield a better influence on the inside than on the outside. There are many ways to lead, and not all of them involve ruling. The throne and the office are only what you bring to it.
We should be able to make our way up there. Ready?
Okay.
plucking a son of Thor out of your memory, of all things. We meet once more, Coast of Sparta. And lest we forget, Kratos, lest we neglect to place your deed in full and proper context, I saved your life. Me! And you literally tore off my head for my troubles. Imagine if all your new friends knew how you used to treat your old friends. Of course, you're not the same man, right? Now, you only get your friends killed through lack of foresight. Far easier to blame others that way, am I right?
I know you are a projection of the mind. But for what it is worth, the death I gave you was unjust.
Oh, how touching. Yeah, not actually worth the spittle it took to mumble that out. Do not do that again. Nobody wants to hear that from you. A little something to remember me by. I truly hope it brings you unrelenting torment. Chills you just a little when they do that, doesn't it? Feels like judgment. Always looking for an edge. Is this a game to you? Slippery bastards, haven't you? Run!
the tether, quickly! It's in the ground! Incoming time!
And we're back. Didn't miss anything too important, did I?
General.
Great progress, but always more to be done.
Sir.
I know it's above board, but I like to think of this part as bribing the local authorities.